Hi, AT from CNC at Home. In the past, we have done a bunch of basic tile etching things where we take a white tile, we take white paint, we spray it on the white tile, we put it in the laser, and then a cool thing happens when we burn it. Most of the paint part just burns off and is dust. Part of what makes white paint white these days is a chemical called titanium dioxide. As you can see, this is a window into this bag. So titanium dioxide is just really nice and white. That's what gives white paint its white coloring. So when we take the white paint, we spray it on the tile, what's happening is the titanium dioxide is what's actually changing. It's changing basically from that white color, it's melting, it's turning black, and it gets gooey and sticky, and it adheres to the tile. It's virtually impossible to scrape off of the tile once that's kind of melted on there. And then that's really cool. And we get stuff like, a tile where it says something, and this is on there permanently. It won't come off. We've got another one. This stuff is on there, and it won't come off. We have done another method where instead of using the white paint, we use a cold galvanizing compound, and a similar kind of process happens. And we found that that's much more consistent, at least I found it's much more consistent, than using the white paint method. Part of the white paint method issue is I am not consistent in coating the tiles. In my mind, it's like, if I get a nice, solid, thick coat on there, that's the best. And what we found in testing is that's not exactly true. You want a very light coat, or maybe two light coats, but light coats. And I want full coverage. So anyway, that's been the problem. And, white paint, you use it, it's kind of expensive. What I want to do then is I want to use just the titanium dioxide. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix the titanium dioxide with some denatured alcohol. And if we think back to our chemistry, we end up with a couple kinds of things. When we mix liquids together, we can have solutions where things melt or blend in together. So if you take water and you put salt in it, or you take water and you put sugar in it, the sugar and the salt would actually dissolve within the water, and it becomes a solution. If you take something that can't dissolve in the water, like a cornstarch or a titanium dioxide, which does not dissolve into the water, you end up with a suspension. And so you get it all stirred up, and the little particles will float around in the water, or in this case, the denatured alcohol. It'll float around for a while, and then we can use the denatured alcohol to help us apply that. I'm going to use a paintbrush. Other methods would be a squirt bottle. I'm going to use the paintbrush method and see how that works. I'm going to try one coat, two coats, and three coats. And I do have four tiles out, so maybe I'll just go ahead and do four coats on one of those as well. Then I will go into light burn and run a material test using the parameters that I know work pretty well for our white paint method, and see how it turns out. And hopefully this will work really well. And if not, well, it's a great experiment. So let's get to mixing and getting the titanium dioxide and denatured alcohol mixture or suspension applied to our tiles, and let those dry. Take them in and do material test on each one of those. See how it turns out. Let's get to painting. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Let's get over to the paint booth. Okay, it's just a table with tiles on it. I have my magic concoction of titanium dioxide and denatured alcohol. It kind of looks like it's a full jar, but it isn't. I put in about this much denatured alcohol and about this much, not quite that much, of the titanium dioxide. So about a 50-50 mix. So we need to make sure this is shaken up, because the titanium dioxide is just going to be suspended in the alcohol. The alcohol then is our medium that we're going to use to get this to spread nicely. Boy, this stuff looks thick. I'm going to need to I'm going to need to put more alcohol in this. This is too thick. Hang on. Let's see how this goes. This may be something that we don't need to do more than one. Wow, look at that. Ooh, that is white. It's no wonder they use titanium dioxide for white paint. I thought the white was hard enough to see. Well, let's get a nice coat on you. I'm running out. It's hard enough to see when it was painted on, but this, wow, this is white. Okay, so we'll just let these dry, and then I will just leave this one as one coat, and this will be two, this will be three, and that'll be four coats. Let's go ahead and get our second coat on here. And we don't need to get much on here because it seems to go on quite easily. It's easier for me to see this, and if I get it in the light just right, it looks pretty good. Oops. I'm thinking just one coat. I mean, looking at how thick this stuff was when it came on, I'm thinking one coat will probably be all we need. And now the denatured alcohol is just a delivery method for this. It evaporates up and it leaves the titanium dioxide behind. And the titanium oxide is not stuck at all to the tile. It's just sitting on there. So if I just brush it with my finger or bump it, it'll come right off. So the cleaning process will be nice and simple. Titanium, as a general rule, is very human friendly, let's say. That's one of the reasons that medical tools, implants, use titanium, because it's less likely to be rejected by the body. The body sees that and says, hey, this is some good stuff. So it's much less of a toxic process. I can do this inside. There's not much of a smell. What smells is this denatured alcohol, and they do that on purpose. They put a smell in it so that people don't drink it, apparently, which is kind of, well, whatever. So I'll let these dry, and I may just stop it too. I'll go ahead and get this one on the laser, see how it burns, and let these other three dry, and we'll go from there. Be the third coat, and seriously, this stuff is on here so thick. Look at that, my goodness. Wow. Okay, I need to go get this cleaned up to see if this stuff actually stuck to the tile or not. But down here at 35% power at 20 mil or 2000 millimeters per minute, it's black. 3800 millimeters per minute at 80% power is black. Even all the way down, it's almost looks like when we get down to about 40%, it's starting to not be consistent. But even at 50% power, it's nice and black at 3800. This means if this stuff doesn't wash off, we can run tiles at 3800 millimeters per minute at 50% power and get a nice black finish. And this is just one coat of the titanium dioxide. I'm going to go get this cleaned up and we'll take a look at it. I'll be right back. Here we go. This cleaned up just in water. Not a big deal. The tile is wet, at least, you know, on the back, so this will need to be dried out. I mean, this is good data. Up here, it is starting to get gray, but over here, it's definitely black. So at 3,800 millimeters per minute, somewhere between 35% and 80% power, you know, here at about the 50-55
12% power. It looks great. So this means we can burn tiles faster, get a much better looking tile. I think this black is just really black. Even compared to the cold galvanizing compound, this turned out really well. And this is just one coat. The mixture I did with the titanium dioxide and the denatured alcohol was about 2 to 1. So 2 parts alcohol, 1 part titanium dioxide. It could even be thinner, I think. And I'll have to experiment around with that a little bit. I do have a project I want to do. I think this method is what I'm going to use for that. I'm going to remake a set of coasters for my brother-in-law, and this will work really well. So this experiment turned out fantastic, first try. We've got some good settings. I'll get this into my library, and we can go from there.
I put the tile underneath the microscope so we can get a close look. This is at 20,000 millimeters per minute at, you know, the medium, the 50 to 55% power. Look how black that is. It's just fantastic. If we go up to the top of the tile at the 3,800 millimeters per minute, it still looks just as rich and as black. So that means we can go really fast and get this really nice full coverage. I'm going to go over to the 35% power here, and it still looks really good. In fact, this looks better than what we usually get from the white paint method. So this is a great process using the titanium dioxide directly. Look at that coverage. It's fantastic.
But if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you like the content of our channel, think about subscribing. And enjoy doing your CNC at home projects. This is great. I love it.